Water supplies are finally returning for thousands of furious customers across the south coast, left high and dry for 19 hours. 10's Hayley Connell joins us live from a very thirsty Victor Harbour.
Well, Beck, water has just been turned back on here in Victor Harbour after it was turned off at about 10 o'clock last night. SA Water is taking a cautious approach to recharging the system, worried that there might be a relapse of what happened overnight. So what they're doing is starting here in Victor Harbour, then letting the water filter through to Port Elliot, then to Middleton, and finally into Goolwa. And of course, it is school holidays, which has made this problem even worse.
Water everywhere, but not a drop to drink.
It's been pretty inconvenient, just in the sense we can't have a shower, there's no drinking water.
There's no showers or baths for grotty kids and parents.
School holiday visitors to the south coast caught up in the big dry. Around 8,000 homes and businesses without water after routine maintenance went wrong.
This was supposed to be a very simple, short job. Idea being to shut the mains down at 10 o'clock last night and have water on in the early hours of the morning.
But as the stoppage dragged on throughout the day, holidays evaporated.
It's pretty bad with school holidays on. The caravan park's full, so there's no one can cook and clean. All have to head home. Yeah, we have no other choice but to go home.
SA Water says the complications set in when water mains began bursting in Victor Harbour at the same time as the routine shutdown.
It is unusual to have three bursts all at the same time, so there must have been a pressure surge.
Crews worked all day to fix faulty equipment, bottled water trucked in for locals as temperatures rose, especially for the unluckiest group of residents who copped a double whammy, no water or electricity.
I pay my rates, I pay good money to have these services, and we're not getting the service.
Lift your game. It's not a third world country anymore.
The fiasco coming after a summer of discontent when the south coast was hit with widespread blackouts. Just as they did back then, many businesses were today forced to close.
We've had a very quiet winter due to economic times and what have you, and now we've got interruption to tourist trade. They'll go somewhere else.
SA Water says it's completely normal for them to conduct this kind of routine maintenance overnight in this area during the school holidays. It's just that nothing like this has ever happened before, and for that they have apologised. They say that any businesses affected should contact their own insurer in the first instance, but if they're not covered for any reason, then they should get in touch with SA Water and they'll try and work out some form of compensation. But for now, hopefully water will be back to normal very soon, and so those on school holidays can get back to relaxing. Beck.
Thank you, Hayley.